morning, children. Today I am going to discuss the topic relative atomic mass and molecular mass and percentage composition of class 9, chapter 1 topic. First of all, relative atomic mass.
Yeah.
industry, we need to calculate the qualitative analysis required, quantitative analysis required. For the quantitative analysis, we need the calculation of the actual mass or weight required for the different chemical reaction, and that is why these atomic weights are very important, because the actual weight is very less, very small values. That is why this relative atomic mass is taken everywhere for the calculation. Okay, so you remember, whatever the, if I am saying 23, this is not the actual mass. 23 means 23 times it is heavier. If I am saying the atomic mass of lithium is 3 or 6, means it is the 6 times heavier than the 1 by 12 mass of carbonate. Similarly, if we talk about the relative molecular mass,
means 1 into 1 copper atom.
weight is your 207. Nitrogen's relative atomic weight is 14 and oxygen's relative atomic mass is 16. Generally, when this type of questions are asked, atomic masses are provided generally. But suppose some very common element like hydrogen, oxygen, some kinds of is not provided clearly. If the elements are very common, then it is supposed that children are knowing the relative atomic masses. So calculate the relative atomic mass, otherwise generally the atomic masses are provided in this question. Now how we will do? Pb NO3 whole twice. And you remember, whole twice means that it is multiplied with all the elements present in inside this bracket. Now how do you get that atom? 1 into weight of lead plus how many nitrogen? Nothing is written, means 1 and nearest 2, that means 2 ones are 2. 2 into weight of nitrogen and how many total atoms of oxygen? 3, and it is whole twice, means in total 3 to the 6, means 6 into weight of oxygen. Okay, now you put the weights. Let's atomic weight is 207 plus 2 into nitrogen is 14 plus 6 into oxygen is 16. Okay, now 207 plus 14 is 28 plus 16 is 96. Okay, then you add it. 86, 14, 14 and 7, 21. Okay, 2, 9 to 11, 12, 13, 13 is here, and 2, 1 and 1. That means 3, 31 a.m.
Calculate the
relative molecular mass of aluminium hydroxide. So the relative molecular mass of aluminium hydroxide, how do you calculate? Just I explain. Here is one atom of aluminium plus three, and here nothing is written, means three ones are three. Three atom of oxygen, and here is again outside three, nothing is written, three atoms of hydrogen. Now put the weight 1 into 27 plus 3 into 16 plus 3 into 1. That means 27 plus 16 threes are 48 and 3 ones are 3. Okay, 7 and 3, 10, 8, 18, 1, 4, 1, 5 and 2, 7. Okay, so relative molecular mass of aluminium hydroxide is 78. Now next is percentage composition. Okay, you have to take out the percentage. The formula of percentage composition is whose percentage you have to take, that weight of the substance. Suppose here, first of all, if you want to take the percentage, so percentage of aluminium, suppose, so weight of aluminium upon molecular mass is relative molecular mass into 100. Of weight, so many times children are getting confused. They are saying that oxygen is 16 here, they are coming to 16. No. The total weight of oxygen means when you calculated the molecular mass, the last line which weight is not 60, it is 3 atom of 60 means 48. The last line you will see, the weight of aluminium is 27. That means 27 upon molecular weight is 78 into 100. Now we will calculate. 3 times are 27, 3 2s are 6, 7, 3 6s are 18, then again 3 3s are 9, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 2 6s are 12, 2 3s are 6, 2 are 25, that means 25 3s are 75 upon 3, that is 3 2's are 6 and 3 5's are 23. 3 also cancel. Okay, 3 5's are 15. That means 25% is your aluminium. Okay, similarly, when you have to calculate the percentage of oxygen, what weight of oxygen upon molecular mass into 100. Okay, weight of oxygen is what here? Last line, that is 48. Molecular weight is your 78 into 100, and you will solve it your good.